2. Cage fucking 2. It does not get any better than this, people. I don't think I've ever been so excited for a sequel in all my life. And I know this is hard to believe, but Cage 2 actually surpasses the original, which puts it in line for being one of the awesomest, most kick-ass movies of all time. Well, how is that possible? Well, in many ways, Cage 2, The Arena of Death, is Cage 1 on steroids. It's got everything. It's got even more cage fighting. It's got better martial artists. And, of course, it's jam-packed wall-to-wall with action movie gods, Lou Ferrigno and Reb Brown.
Stars action hero Lou Ferrigno, Rob Brown.
Blasphemy!
Billy, you want some cookies?
Yeah.
Following the violent events of the first movie, Reb and Lou have rebuilt their bar and returned to their normal lives, never suspecting that Mr. Takagi not only survived his crushed sternum and broken back, but he would also somehow crawl out of the building, escape the police dragnet, restart his illegal cage-fighting death matches, and actually expand them to having worldwide televised pay-per-views. Man, you thought the police were a joke before. How do they manage not to find this? They've got one huge location, camera crews, a broadcast uplink, and a studio audience. And hey, look, they've even got Nicolas Cage from Deadfall as their announcer.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Vinny Rosenbaum, and this is the Cage Cable Network event we've all been waiting for. Our annual International Tournament of Champions.
It should be an action-packed night of death and brutality. Be sure not to miss it.
Well, as my father used to say, if you can't stand the heat, stay out of the kitchen.
This guy just sounds so bored. Anyway, don't think Mr. Takagi's forgotten about Reb and Lou, because he sends a triad hit squad to hunt them down. Gangsters storm into the supermarket, where Reb was just securing a hot date with two chicks at the same time, and start shooting up the place. Lou tries to make the save, but the bad guy leader shoots him with a tranquilizer dart, and they wheel him away.
Billy! Billy! Billy!
I like how Reb doesn't even bother checking to see if the two ladies he uses as a meat shield are alright. Anyway, next we see Lou. He's back in the cage as the reigning champion, defending his title against... Malibu? The guy from Dragon Strike?
I've never seen anything so brutal.
Good God Almighty, he's killed him. As God is my witness, he's broken in half.
Don't worry, folks. This movie was a long time ago. Let's take it back to the arena where Mike Adamley's having a word with a returning Malibu.
I saw this guy coming, and I took the most excellent hit of my life. And I'm fine today.
So no hospital, no doctors, just Mother Nature, huh?
Oh, I'm a child of Mother Nature. What do you expect?
Malibu, you are truly amazing. He took a licking, and he is still ticking.
Yeah, so you might have noticed that Lou's kind of giving a different performance in this movie. They really dialed back on the gentle giant with brain damage thing.
I like wrestling.
In favor of, well, this.
Well, give me better fighters. The guy was nothing.
It's mostly because Mr. Takagi's been giving Lou steroid injections to make him stronger and more aggressive. Yes, he's giving Lou Ferrigno steroids. And once he's on the steroids, the dude becomes unstoppable, to the point they have to start putting him in matches against two or more opponents to even make it a competitive fight. They're treating this poor guy like he's some pit bull. I mean, this is sick. The guy's got brain damage. I guess you could call them handicap matches. Oh, come on! Wait, what? What the fuck? I did not add that.
The triad make over $20 million through worldwide pay-per-view every time they televise cage fights.
$20 million a show. Mr. Takagi's making so much money out of this big freak, he even put a lesbian jacuzzi in his office. That's how you know you are officially pimp of the world, when you have an area in your office dedicated solely to the purpose of having hot Chinese chicks soaping each other's breasts at all times. Anytime he wants to see boobies, he just looks over and why, hello, lesbians. How does the guy get any work done? I don't know. I guess after a month or two, even the lesbian jacuzzi would start to get a little boring. And it's like buying a foosball table. It's fun for the first week or so, but after a while, you use it less and less, and then you just stop noticing it. While Lou's been steamrolling his competition, Reb's been searching for the cage fights on his own, but somehow not having any luck.
No fight action!
Just drink, yeah, I know.
He's about to give up when suddenly he's contacted by two friendly karate masters.
What the hell are you doing here?
I will answer all your questions if you'll please sit down.
Why don't I just throw your butt out of here?
Please sit down, Miss Monroe. I must insist.
You can insist all you want! This is bullshit! Who are you guys?
As I told you, I am Sho Tanaka. And this is Zindio Ogami. We're with Interpol.
These guys just feel like they're from a completely different movie, like they're just here to promote some new martial arts cop show with Sammo Hung. There's like three fight scenes featuring Master Ogami fighting triad dudes all by himself. He's that badass, and I hate to say it, but he's actually a way cooler character than Reb in this flick, who spends most of the movie just whining like a bitch.
I'm safe here.
Oh, great. All I wanted to do is find Billy.
We have any more good luck? I'll be dead.
Oh, swell. Well, this is special, Tanaka. If I leave my room, I'll be shot. If Yin finds me, I'll be shot. I can tell I'm gonna have a great time with you guys. Oh, swell.
Now what?
Jeez, now what?
Oh, yeah. Right.
Oh. Having just enlisted Reb to help crack open the fighting ring, they step out of the apartment only to find about a dozen hitmen surrounding them in the hall.
What's Master Ogami grinning about?
He likes the odds.
Oh, swell.
Why do none of the bad guys just use a gun? Because this is way less conspicuous. Anyway, the Asian Jay and Silent Bob here know where the Arena of Death is, but for some reason they can't just call in the SWAT team and arrest everyone. Now, the much more sensible plan is to teach Reb martial arts.
I have a black belt.
Great, use it to hold up your pants.
Okay, teach him more martial arts, and then send him undercover as a fighter, make him fight a bunch of people, and... somehow this all ends up with Mr. Takagi being arrested.
That little guy's a martial arts master?
Size matters not. Look at me. Judge me by my size, do you?
So Reb reluctantly agrees to study the art of fighting with Master Ogami after they make it clear the level of competition in the cage is higher than it's ever been before. But it's clear that he's got a lot to learn.
Hey, what's the problem?
Stop embarrassing me, Monroe.
Wait a minute. A young foolhardy hero? A wise karate mentor? A major martial arts tournament coming up? I think it's time for a textbook action movie training montage! Oh, yeah. Wait, what the fuck? Bullshit! Where's the training montage? This is where you're supposed to put the training montage with the kick-ass music and the running and the punching and... All we get is 5 seconds of him doing white belt punching exercises, then they cut away? Oh, he's ready for the cage after that, no doubt. That's all the training we ever see. After that, Master Ogami just drives him straight to the arena. No shit. He must have just mastered martial arts faster than fucking Neo in The Matrix. It still kills me how Lou Ferrigno gets more fucking training footage than Reb in this movie, and the movie's supposed to be about Reb overcoming the odds.
Milo, you think I'm losing weight?
Do these sweatpants make Hulk butt look big?
You have so many muscles, Philippe. Did it take a very long time to make such bigness?
Yeah. I started working out when I...
Hulk feel great disturbance in force, as if millions of voices cried out, then were silenced.
Actually, Lou's starting to have some serious health problems after his fights. It seems the steroid injections are causing major chest pains.
Billy Thomas seems to be having greater distress than I first perceived. His heart could burst at any time.
Ah, Mr. Takagi don't care, though. He's got Lou wrapped around his little finger, and he'll use him up like a baby wipe.
I'm really sorry that I hurt you, Mr. Yin, but I thought you were trying to hurt my friends.
But now you know I was trying to help you and your friends. It was those bad people who tried to cause you pain.
They don't trust you, Anakin.
I know that now, Mr. Yin. I'm sorry. Okay?
Yes, I've forgiven you, Billy. That is why I'm taking care of you now that Scott is dead.
Thank you, Mr. Yin. You're a good man.
Good. I want to tell you, I've always thought of you as a son.
Henceforth, you shall be known as Darth Vader.
But Lou is saved from the dark side when he falls in love with Milo, one of Mr. Takagi's slave girls who convinces him to get off the smack. And you can imagine how well this goes over.
Let her go, Billy. She's a whore from the streets.
Don't you know what a whore is?
Yeah! I know what a whore is. I know what a friend is. And I know what scum is. Now get out and leave us alone or I'll kill you right here.
Wow. I guess steroids cure brain damage. You'd think after the first time Lou crushed his sternum like it was made of bubble wrap, he'd learn not to tease the fucking giant!
We will make over $60 million here today when Billy wins. Perhaps we should force him to take that injection.
How?
By the way, here is $3 million with which to make additional bets.
$3 million in what? $1,000 bills? You can't fit $3 million in that! Anyway, Tanaka tells Reb they know what he looks like and would shoot him on sight, so they make him wear a disguise.
Hey, you look great.
Oh, come on. What do they do, buy the costume at Walmart? He looks like a Spanish conquistador. Actually, my first thought was he kind of looks like Locklear from Betrayal at Krondor. Oh, God. I just made a Betrayal at Krondor reference in 2011. I don't get out much. Wait a minute, why is Master Ogami laughing at him? The last scene they had together, they were driving to the arena, and he was in costume, and he's only now noticing this? I don't know. I guess it is one of those things that never really stops being funny every time you see it.
I have other news.
Yes?
Scott Monroe is here with the man from Interpol.
Okay, hang on. So they know he's there? How did they see through that masterful disguise? And why did they let him fight? Why don't they just kill him? Naturally, Reb has to fight a bunch of lesser fighters before he can get to Lou, all in one night, of course. Mr. Takagi's still a big believer in that whole you must fight again in 30 minutes thing. Did someone just wake up the Foley artist? I guess he was either asleep before or just couldn't find the gong effect on the CD he bought from Sam Goody. These are some of the worst and most obvious stock sound effects I think I've ever heard in a movie. It really is like the guy in charge of Foley just bought a CD, but all it had was two effects of punches and male grunting on it. I guess he decided the Wilhelm scream wasn't entirely appropriate to the scene, though, because we hear this scream a half dozen times when Lou fights a Russian heavyweight. Yeah. Reb has a rough time of it, though, barely defeating a Thai kickboxer who kicks the shit out of his leg. But Reb manages to overbear the guy and rock some jujitsu, locking in a cross-arm breaker, which he just lets go of for no reason before switching to a choke and then just outright murdering the guy. Oh, God. Lots of neck snapping going on here.
Damn! I didn't mean to kill that little guy.
Yes, you did!
I just got word you're gonna fight the great one next.
If you smell what the Rock is cooking.
When you get in the cage, tell them pretend to knock you out, and when they carry you out, I'll start a fire. Since the FBI knows our every move, they'll come right away as soon as they see the smoke.
Well, if you have to set the building on fire to signal them, I guess the FBI doesn't know your every move, does it? I guess this is what cops had to do before cell phones and radios. You know, you really have to question any plan that involves setting the building you're in on fire, but I guess everyone else seems confident in it. Reb finally squares off in the ring with Lou, but I think Reb forgets that Lou's character has significant brain damage. In fact, Mr. Miyagi here has to rip off the wig because it doesn't even occur to Reb to try taking off his fucking disguise. I'm actually surprised the wig came off that easy, considering it somehow stayed on when this Taekwondo expert was roundhouse kicking him in the fucking face. Once the friends are finally reunited, the fire alarm goes off, creating a huge panic in the crowd. Cue the stock screaming sound effects!
Calm down, it's okay, calm down!
Wait, I gotta find Milo. She helped me, I love her.
Okay, Billy.
And of course, Lou completely screws up the entire plan immediately by going to get his girlfriend, where he runs smack into Mr. Takagi.
All right, you overgrown simpleton.
Ooh, I hope he activates some kind of super science-y thing on his brace that gives him super strength and speed like in Mantis and they fight. That would be fucking awesome.
Brace, the cane, the broken back, and all the years of agonizing pain?
What you say? That you only meant well, but of course you did. What you say? That it's all for the best, of course it is. What you say? That it's just what we need. You decided this.
Why are you running? Keep shooting him. Are you mad? I guess Mr. Takagi can really move when he needs to because he's already calling for a helicopter and leaving bodyguards to block the way.
Where is Jin?
He's gone, Billy boy. Now it's just you and me.
This guy's awfully confident for facing a dude twice his fucking size who's been murdering people in a cage for over 3 years. And guess what? He gets his scrawny ass kicked.
What you say? That you only meant well, but of course you did. What you say? That you only meant well, but of course. What you say? That you only meant well, but of course you did.
Yeah, try pulling the trigger about 10 more times. I'm sure there's a bullet in there somewhere. Fake cops. When you can't afford real cops. They didn't even attempt to make them look like real police cars. It's just the producer's cars with red lights on top. Well, the fake cops form a perimeter around the, loading dock, and thugs just keep pouring out of cover in broad daylight to attack them. Check out the balls on this guy! Now that's how you go out in a blaze of glory. Come out shooting two guns like a John Woo movie. And they just keep running out in the open. These guys have the artificial intelligence of a video game from the 90s. Then Reb runs into the same bodyguard who's still spoiling for a fight even after Lou Ferrigno just handed him his ass.
But you won't walk away from this fight.
Save your breath, asshole. You're gonna need it.
You've been practicing.
Practicing? Last few days, all I've done is fight.
Yeah, I practiced for like 2 whole days. Reb's at a real disadvantage, though, since he's already fought 4 people today, and the guy works his injured leg.
You're not much better than your feeble-minded friend.
Billy, where is he?
He's dead! You shot him!
Well, after that, Reb lays an unholy beating on the guy and hangs him on the spot. Oh, jeez, guys, who tied a rope with 12 nooses and just left it there? This was bound to happen. Anyone could just fall into that. Why would you do that? Come on!
That's for Billy, asshole.
Ugh, puns, Reb. One-liners, I keep telling you, man. Hang out for a while. You're a real pain in the neck. You're yesterday's noose. Damn it!
Did you find Billy? You didn't kill them.
Well, at least that's what that one guy told me. I didn't really check. I figure, why would the guy possibly lie?
You left your best friend in a burning building, you asshole! But then they see Mr. Takagi's getting to the choppa.
Son of a bitch is gonna get away!
Oh, now wait a minute. What the hell?
You're kidding.
Master Ogami has a fucking rocket launcher? Well, that was fucking random. He's got a rocket launcher? Since fucking when? It's like this movie was written by the same kid who does Axe Cop. He's a ninja with a fucking law. And this reaction shot is fucking priceless.
Get that son of a bitch!
And I'm not even kidding, this is how the movie ends. I swear to you, I did nothing to this footage. What kind of ending was that? Were they actually trying to set the hook for another sequel? Because there wasn't one. Why couldn't they just have Lou kill Mr. Takagi at the end, or have him be in the helicopter when it blew up? Who just writes a story where an old guy spontaneously whips out a bazooka? Oh, shut up.
Cry out in the night as they grow restless, longing for some solitary.
Tanaka! No, Tanaka! You don't understand! I really do have a black belt!